What is it do? Come and get some. Renfro.
I don't have the 96 or the 90. But hey, I'm good to it. That's good stuff. Just in case. So yeah, and then Mel Renfro is this guy. I found him for 6,000 points. Okay. Literally, this guy. He's usually 127,000. That's the power up my run throw. Power up card. This is it. He has 85 speed, 84 acceleration, 18 agility, 87 jumping, 84 player connection, 86 man coverage, 86 zone, and 74 press. So he's not a presser. Night Train can press. Pretty much. Alright, Pat Tillman cannot press. Okay, look at his press. Yeah. He's like our worst card. Yeah. Jason Sehorn. He's worse than Jason Sehorn. That card's a beast. That's all I can say. It's a beast. Let's see if we can make him kick. Ooh, 94 kick return? Okay, yeah, he's our new kick return. Cause we gotta give him some room, you know? I mean, it's not like I'm trying to waste all of his energy. So, actually, our kick returner will be... Who will it be? Pat Tillman. No, I'm just kidding. Bro, Devontae Parker is literally almost as fast as Bo Jackson. Yeah, literally. They want to keep me. Oh, that's a good one. So we will use Kyrie at kick returner. Now Renfro punt return because he can tackle whenever they fake it. And yeah. So that's our line. Let's see if we get more players in the Mel Renfro set, actually. Because I need to have this full card. Best full card, I mean, hotel, lobby. Not the 96 overall. Yeah. 12 out of 33. That's more than half. I'm just kidding. Alright, 2,000. Awuzie. Still plays for Cowboy. I don't know why. Jadobi. Awuzie. Yeah, that's his name. Awuzie. I don't know why. George. Too expensive, I live in it. And Joe Looney is like the most expensive one on it. Ooh, 9,000, never mind. Yeah, I'm gonna be getting that Joe Looney today. Like Joe Looney. Alright. Since he's 900, I think we can get another card for 600. Theme Diamond Cowboys. This guy's literally cheap.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Taco Charlton. Wow. Thank you for making them insanely cheap. So, I think that's all we can get. For today. All we're gonna get today. So, that's almost more than half. We need 17. Two more to have more than half. All we need is George Iloka, Joe Looney, being moved in a frenzy. Gregory, Connor Williams, Xavier Woods, Robert Quinn, Anthony Brown, Michael Dowd, Earl Collins, Casey Witten, Randy Pott, Tyrone Crawford, John Charles Frederick, Byron Jones, Blake Van Der Esch, Amari Cooper, DeMarcus Walsh. We literally need like 50,000 coins. We got it hot like fever. 50,000 more coins. Passing your receiver. All about running the spot. And you know we got breath control. Let's get into our season. We got one win. We pulled off. And you know we can't wait. Because his connection was locked. He literally had some of the best cards. Ted Hendricks. Yeah. So, let's get into the game. We might be playing a lot of games today, but could we get to the playoffs again? Just to the playoffs. Because we just made it last video. I don't know why it gave us a loss. Oh, and by the way, last video we pulled the Bonte card. So yeah. But no Renfro. He got us picked last game, actually. Last video. He has an INT that made him quit, that made us lose.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line.
Let's do a stretch. Do a stretch run.
They'll start here with Jackson. The game's first play produces 6 yards, brings up second down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game. Brings up second and 4 at the
33-yard line. Falcons all the way. Put me in, I can throw. Rise up.
The last run got 6, now second and 4.
In the zone.
On second down, this is Jackson. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Atlanta.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it could be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
24 is the mic. It's our time. It's our time.
First down, Vic. Going deep here for Parker.
Muscle.
And a double coverage and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 11. And the return just out across the 15 to the 16-yard line. Parker, the intended target. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts.
No, skip this.
So after the INT, it's Manning. He's got Gore, first down of end zone. Finally taken down to the 32-yard line. It'll go as a first down for San Francisco on a pickup of 16. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now Manning on the bootleg. This one complete to Mecole Hardman. A good pick up there, 26 yards. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way
into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the former 49er, Deion Sanders. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They'll begin the drive with Jackson on the ground. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. Timmy Jernigan, the Florida State man, in on the stop. On second down, it's Jackson. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that'll force upon him a third and 14. Looks for Parker, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 35. And he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. He was looking for Parker that time. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turned to block, find the spot. And now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. An 18-yard touchdown grab as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two receptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
On second and 11 now. Vic, he's going to let one go deep for Parker. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Devontae Parker, the intended receiver, and that takes us from second to third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Working out of the gun, Michael Vick, buying time to his left. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 47. On the run, it's Bo Jackson. And he's going to be met at about the 43. The Hall of Famer Ty Law coming up from the secondary to make the tackle.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
He's got the first down here inside the 30, and he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal. They'll run now with Bo Jackson. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line here, second and goal. Toss play to Jackson. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
So they're back at the 7 now for 3rd and goal. Vic goes play action. Oh, and now Vic throwing another interception. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. He's at the 50, the 40, past the 20, 10, and into the end zone. A pick six for the 49er D as they score the touchdown. So that's now 3 first-half interceptions, and that last one even costlier as it's returned for 6 points. So as a quarterback, how do you regain your focus?
Well, QB 101 says you never show them that you're sweating. Still act like you're the guy that you've thrown 6 touchdown passes, not 3 interceptions. But he's human. He's got to face up to his teammates. He's got to own up to that. See if he can brace up and also not look over his shoulder and see his backup starting to warm up. It's going to be a tough one for him.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence, and that's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 23 yards the pick up there. They'll run on first down. Peyton. And he's got this down to the 35. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for a first down for the Falcons.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Back off the ball again. Oh!
He'll get the first down and more inside the 12. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. In for the score as they are now on the board here in the first half.
That appeared like any routine NFL quarterback, but it was Michael Vick from the pocket, throws a touchdown pass. I just think about the transformation throughout his career. From Atlanta, where he would take off and go at just about the drop of a hat and turn defenses into mush, and then by the end of his career in Philadelphia, where he completed pass like we just saw from the pocket, yet still had those great legs, when necessary, to help get him out of trouble.
This will be taken very short. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. Now a play fake here on first down, eluding the pressure right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. Throwing again, Manning. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. He's got his man, that's Hardman. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Well, Charles, you and I have made our predictions for Super Bowl 54. Well, coming soon, the official Madden NFL 20 Super Bowl prediction, something Madden folks do every year is predict how they think the big game is going to play out. And that prediction, with the help, by the way, from Peyton and Eli Manning, is going to be revealed on Thursday, January 30th, 9 Eastern. Go to ea.com/the prediction to check it out. And keep playing Madden to feed the machine and tell us who you think will win as well. Again, it's ea.com/the prediction. Fans, a reminder. I have a note card here that says ad lib halftime preview. So I guess let's do just that as we'll hand things over to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando when this one reaches halftime. Did I do okay?
You did great. Not a bad job.
Hey.
You know, writing down your ad lib.
If you print it, I'm going to read it. I'm Brandon Gaudin. Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five. Here's Manning to throw. And this is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. On first down. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. It's a gain of 11, and the Falcons pick up the first. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They run the counter. Jackson. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
It's a gain of 11, and the Falcons pick up the first. Here's Michael Vick. Being chased out left. His throw incomplete. He was trying to get it to sweetness, Walter Payton. And that'll bring up second down.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit. But only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of one there. On third down, Vic. And it's caught by Parker. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. From 17 yards out, as his guys can now. And oh, he takes off with it. It's a fake. Michael Vick, he's going to go. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more. Following the touchdown, here's Stenerud to kick it away. This is taken at the three. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Under a minute to play here in the half. Time for a late drive.
It makes sense when you think about it. Hey, try and get a field goal. Give yourself a lead going into the half. But if you're going to do this, you better have supreme trust in your quarterback. Supreme trust in the guy's going to handle the football. Because if you turn it over here, not only do you go in down at the half, you've given the momentum squarely to your opponent.
Completes it to Hardman. He'll have a first down past the 40. 17 yards on the catch and run. It's a first down.
That crossing route is so effective when you hit it just right because you get a guy on the move, and then we see the end result there.
Nightmare for the defense. They got a guy with a full head of steam.
Not only does he catch it, but he picks up additional yardage after it.
But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you go make a play on the football.
And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. On third down, Payton. And he's got the first down before being taken down at the 46. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. They'll run on first down. Payton, the linebacker Ryan Shazier there to make the tackle. On second and 7, Manning is going to take a shot at the end zone. Why not? And that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock. Mecole Hardman, the intended target. But now it's third down.
He's not.
Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is third and 7.
He should throw it.
One final try now for Manning. He's going to throw one up for the end zone. And it's intercepted at the goal line.
Give me that.
Picked up by nine-time Pro Bowler Ed Reed.
No!
His time is now running on this first half of action. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
So after the penalty, we'll have one final untimed play here before halftime. This will be the final play of the half. Vic, he's going to take a shot at the end zone. Why not? And that is incomplete. Showing off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three.
Oh, my God.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. From the gun, it's Manning. Finding Hardman here over the middle. And he'll get it out to midfield. They'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. So second and inches after that first down completion. We're just shy of the marker. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Throwing now is Manning.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. On play action, it's Manning. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver up and downfield as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It's way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they look to throw. Got it's caught inside the 10. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the 1. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal.
And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line. Because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
Well, they've been so good on third down all day long. Can they convert another here on third and goal? They'll try and push it in with Gore. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. Fourth down now after a loss of 2.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out, but I don't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, no one did all of that.
About set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense, we got the lead. Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done. I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
Oh,
Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. Vic to throw it. Over the middle, complete. That's Holt. And able to get it across the 10 to the 15. 14 yards there and a Falcon first down.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence. When in doubt, find your veterans.
He used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
I'm making him go on
On second and 11 now. Vic is going to float this one deep right side. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Vic. He may try and run for this. That looks stripped. He lost the football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. So the fumble recovery, and now Manning. They'll give him a yard on the play, and that'll make this a second down. Throwing again on second down, Manning. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
It is tough to complete pass against zone defenses. The windows that you see open, they shrink pretty rapidly. How about being able to hit a moving target against a zone before the next guy can get there and make a play on the ball?
Not easy for any quarterback, no matter the situation. There, the defense won the battle. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7.
They really love to get him into one-on-one opportunities, and this is one way. Work him out of the slot and create a mismatch. Who's going to cover him? Corner, safety, linebacker? He's got a way to beat all of those positions.
Again, they'll throw with Manning.
No way, OT.
A big seam, and he might go all the way. He's at the 50, the 30. The 20, 10, and he will score. Touchdown, Falcons.
Brandon, we spent time with this team before the game, and there was never any indication that they did not like their kicker.
Well, it shows right now that they didn't like their kicker. Why didn't they just put it through the goalpost and take the lead?
That is going to be the question that has to be answered. I don't know about you, but I'm skipping my flight. I'm going to the post-game press conference to find out what they were thinking.
Instead of playing conservative, they go through the air, and what a stunning turn of events. Extra point by Stenerud, up and good. And that makes this a 9-point game. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This will be fielded at the 8. Rumi run. He's at the 40. 20. 10. Touchdown. 49ers. That a 92-yard kick return. As they have now chopped this lead down to 3.
Well, partner, anytime you see a big-time kickoff return, especially one that ends up in the end zone for a touchdown, that's probably the most exciting 10 seconds in the great game of football.
I think it was our friend Ed Brady that told us that one day. Shotgun now for Manning. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. Back now in the East Bay, where the fourth quarter will begin with a kickoff following the score on the final play of the third quarter. Short kick here, fielded about the 17. The Red Sea parts, and there he goes. And the Falcons are in for the touchdown. A big-time special teams play here in the fourth quarter to extend their lead.
And coaches preach it all the time. If you can score on special teams, your chances of winning the game really jump up in a big way. Now, I'll let our analytics friends quantify it and give us the exact numbers, but that's what coaches talk about all the time, that extra momentum, that extra bounce you get from a special team score.
I don't have any analytics friends. Those are your friends.
I'll claim them.
And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway.
Hey, Wood. Christian, be grip.
On first and 10, here's Manning. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11. Working from the gun, Manning. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. And 3 yards there. Takes him to the 45.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Manning looking to throw on third and 2. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
How about that? One of the so-called little guys putting the pressure on. That was a strong safety. When I was in college, we often called that a lightning blitz.
Manning indeed going for it on 4. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And no, it's incomplete. The Niners go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. On first down, Peyton. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. Vic Beasley able to make the tackle. Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6.
Yeah, safety value and this is fun. Maybe you'll push it out the window. You can tell how I'm chewing the clock.
They run the counter. Jackson. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of 1, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down. From the gun, Vic. Flushed out right. He can run for it, and he will. Oh, no, he lost the football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And a short return will be stopped inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. He's going to let it fly. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off at the 47. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. Mecole Hardman, the intended target. They'll run on first down. It's Jackson. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. So they come up on 2nd down, and they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing.
Yeah, well, we didn't get no highlight on that one, so, but hey, anyway.
Now Michael Vick. Flush to his right, and he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags, and I believe this is going to be a 1st down. Reggie White on the sack there, showing the explosiveness that led him to the Hall of Fame. They run the counter. It's Jackson, and he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. They're down here in the 4th, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration. Not a good play.
Again, it's Jackson as he'll stay on the ground. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down. Now from the 9, here's second and goal. Well, they're going to throw it here with Vic. And that's a touchdown late in this affair.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two. And all he takes off with it, it's a fake.
Oh, Dean, it doesn't chew the clock. I thought that chewed the clock. Oh, my God.
Now Vic's stripped. He lost the football.
No.
Look at this, Mellis. It's 2 points the other way on the fumble return. Here's Stinnerud to kick it away. Five underway. And last time, this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it.
And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked up by a former Niner legend in Ronnie Lott. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. Well, it wasn't always pretty, but the interception there, that means that they should get out of here with a victory.
Yeah, this is not a game that they're going to preserve for posterity on defense, but they did finish it off, didn't they? They did make the winning play, but he did have a teammate on the spot.
Knee here.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw with the home team.
So first and second down went in the wrong direction. They'll try to do better here on third and third.
So it came down to the third quarter. Hope we get someone back through a screen off this guy. It'd be better for
better ball security, but not
flies in like a missile to stop that one.
Vic.
Eye open.
Decker complete. And getting it.
And
those big runs between the tackles. Five, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
From the 29, Brady, it's caught. This is right. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
Now a first down carry. It's Michelle. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it. So those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Oh, I'm getting ran.
From the 45 on second down, Brady got a man. It's Randy Moss complete. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 34-yard line.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Brady now got to leave it with Michelle on the draw. And get the first down and Lawrence and the 20. And all the way down to the 17-yard line. 17 yards there for the Patriots as they've got themselves a first down. They'll run it here. This is James White. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
That's why.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports.
First 53.
On second down, Michelle.
No, no need to run. I'm not blitzing for some reason.
And he's going to get it inside the 10 to the 7 yard line. A gain of 8 there on the 8th play of the drive.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
And he's going to get into the end zone. So cue up the Gronk spike. It's a Patriot touchdown.
Well,
a 7-yard touchdown grab as they are now on the board here in the first half. Vinatieri connecting on the extra point,
right,
and we are tied at 7.
We're touching and get a pick 6. So take the lead by a lot.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This will be taken short. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play. And that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. Throwing on second and 8. Vic in trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Rob Ninkovich in there to bury him for a loss of 11. After the sack, they'll come up now 3rd and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Going deep here for Parker. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. The veteran Stephon Gilmore able to break that one up.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on 3rd down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. 3rd down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
They'll run on 1st down. Michelle. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again 2nd and 10. Now Brady. On the crossing route, that's caught. Julian Edelman. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. The last play on the completion got them half of what they needed. Now here's a tough 3rd and 5. Brady gonna throw. And that is incomplete.
I think that's a big-time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he was able to bat it away.
Brady not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it here on 4th.
Recon, 152, fight it.
He'll go for it. It's Brady. This will be caught by Randy Moss. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the 1st half. All knotted up at 7. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coach's 2-minute drill.
That is now 19-yard gains on back-to-back plays.
I like that one, partner. They go back-to-back with excellent gains, and really it shouldn't be a surprise who they were throwing the ball to. He's their best guy.
Yeah, we knew that they would get him involved early. They're doubling down on getting him involved early.
Don't be surprised if they'll come right back to him again. They're going to show the propensity to be able to stop him.
Now we'll run it. This is Michelle, and he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal.
Brady really a gambler. I mean, you can only get user picks.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4 yard line, second and goal. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal.
Brandon, if I wanted to run the football this close to the goal line, I think I'd just turn around and hand it to my tailback. Too many things could go wrong in this situation. I think they're fortunate just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
This is caught, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. From 4 yards out, and the Patriots have taken the lead.
See, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point, because you've got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. That 7-0 lead of theirs is short-lived as they've now given up 2 straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 as they line up, 2nd and 10. To throw again, Vic. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's 3rd down. Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. From the shotgun, it's Vic. Going up top. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Devin McCourty picks it off. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line.
Well, I tell you, Brandon, this ball's intercepted, but it is 3rd down. So the silver lining is that since this is so far down the field and there wasn't a big run back associated with it, really this kind of works like a punt. It's not an altogether bet.
And now nothing but green ahead of him. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. That one's good for 35 yards on the ground and a 1st down.
I know that play went to the left side, and that's what it was designed to do, an outside handoff there. But how about the whole offensive line being involved? Seal the left side where the play was going, where they call play side. But how about on the back side? Just taking care of business to make sure no one can get there and disrupt it.
Is the biggest key the left tackle?
Without a doubt. Control that edge. Get out there. You want that left tackle, if you bring your tight end over there. Either way, control the edge of the line of scrimmage. You've got a chance to rumble.
Able to get 7 on that 1st down pass play. 2nd and 3. It's complete. James White. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. Brady now, only one pass has hit the ground for him. 10 of 11 thus far. It's 1st and 10. From the gun, it's Brady. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Night Train Wayne. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. You're under 30 seconds to go. Field position not great. Time to call it a half, wouldn't you say?
Well, you know we all have that little extra gene that says let's push the envelope a little bit, right? What needs to be going through the play caller's mind right now, a potential fumbled snap that can get returned, a strip sack that can get returned, right? Any of those types of plays, that should be a deterrent to calling something that could get you in big trouble.
And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the 2nd quarter. Shot before break. Vic trying to lay one up deep. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. So here we go for half number two. The Patriots with the lead, and they will be getting the football. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but... not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line.
Oh my God, he's so dumb.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they'll go a little bit deeper into their playbook. What they did in the first half, that worked okay, but in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit, change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
Let's see if they do just that. Now on second and 16, Brady. This will be caught by Brown. And he'll lose yardage here. Back to the 15. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down. The last completion actually lost a yard, so now they'll need to convert on third down. Here's Brady to throw, and that is incomplete. So it would appear they will not be able to add to their lead on this opening drive of the second half.
Yeah, if another touchdown was scored there, now we're talking about a two-score game, and they're probably on their way of creating an excellent gap between them and their pursuers. But how about the defense there able to step up and keep themselves in this one?
They'll take it a few steps in front of the 50. Falcons! 51 yards there on the return punt, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game.
And that jumps the excitement level up a few notches, doesn't it? What a big-time punt return for a touchdown. Now their cohorts on the special team side, they've got to add the PAT.
That would be the equalizer. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away.
A big, big comeback.
This will be taken very short. And his guys are going to start their drive right at the 20-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. They go play action here on first down. That's complete to White. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
It's a loss of four. Now third down.
Yes, Reggie White. I remember when they first started calling him the Minister of Defense. It was back in the University of Tennessee, snuffing out plays like that. Did you see that tackle for a loss? I remember him turning around the LSU game in 1983 with a similar play. Reggie White, one of the all-time greats.
13-time Pro Bowler Reggie White. Throwing is Brady on third down. Slant route, caught by Edelman. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down. Brady, 13 of 16 throwing the football. It's first and 10.
Check, 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 check. Hey, check it. Hey, Charlie. Regular, regular.
Shotgun now for Brady. Got a man, it's Randy Moss. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A very solid gain of 27. Brady now. Five straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. Six-time Pro Bowler Randy Moss, the intended receiver. And it's second down.
So Randy Moss is actually worse.
Wait, that's 53.
Throwing again, Brady. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 12-yard line. Under a minute to go in this third quarter as they come up first and 10. Brady gives to Michelle. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. A 12-yard touchdown run as his guys are able to regain the lead. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep your assignments. Let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
Vinatieri able to tack on the PAT. And the lead is now 21-14. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. About set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within? Accelerating, and off he goes. Past the 20. Touchdown, Falcons. A great play there. 73 yards as they are an extra point away now from and all he takes off with it. It's a fake. And this play is not going to work. He's out of bounds, well shy of the goal line, and a try for two, unsuccessful. Following the touchdown, here's Stenerud to kick it away. This is taken at his 4. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. One play has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. They'll run with Michelle. And nothing but daylight ahead. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Sony Michel, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Patriots, they add on to their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
And it's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is taken at his 4. And he will be taken down here on the return on what will wind up being the final play of this third quarter. Back now in the East Bay. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. It's the Falcons, they'll have the football, but trailing on the scoreboard as we get set to begin the fourth. Ray Lewis up from his linebacker spot to make the play. Throwing on second and 8. Vic, he cannot get away. Down goes Vic. Ryan Shazier came in there hard on the blitz and got him down 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage. Here's Michael Vick. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Vic now. He's going to float this one deep right side. That's going inside the 20. Fourth down.
He's quitting.
Plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. 12 more yards there and another first down.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle.
Oh, no, he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
I know one thing, the team that had the ball and was driving, they're going to feel horrible. But the team that was on defense, they've got to get a little bit of credit, able to hang in there and force a key turnover.
In the red zone, though, had a chance to tie it and an opportunity missed. Had a bit of a lane there, took advantage of it. Give him 7 there on the first down carry. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3. Brings up 2nd and 3 at the 18-yard line. A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. Covered beautifully. Their defenders stay home and they'll stop him behind the line. That second down play nets a -4. New England on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Whistles now and a timeout defensively. So a wise move as they'll use the first of their timeouts to force one more play before the 2-minute warning. To throw on third down, Brady. That's to his running back, Sony Michel. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Brady's pass there, complete to Gronkowski. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. On the ground, Michelle. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down. The Falcons going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Now Michelle. And he's got some space here. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Sony Michelle.
I shouldn't, but guys, it's been a bad game for us, so. Yep. Hate to see it, man. Hate to see it. So we've lost that game, which we all know. I just wanted to get the win.
Are you ready for some football?
That's still some fun, baby. Like, every one win is, like, some more players.
down in Mississippi and New Orleans. Big Snoop Dogg got a Madden league.
So we're going against 2022. Really won't learn, but if you do, come and get some.
See, tell your mama and tell your daddy. And tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy.
Winning this tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Come get some if you want some. But you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none.
I'm Big Snoop Dogg, and I'm the only one. And when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Now the elder statesman of the NFL, Adam Vinatieri, set to get us started. And here we go. We're underway in Madden Ultimate Team. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he'd taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. You come in here, you dial up that pass play on the first play from scrimmage and get it picked.
And you know coaches always talk about we prepare for every eventuality. You don't even mention this as a possibility when you dial up that play, right? Instead, they throw a pick, and now they're behind the eight ball on the road to get things going. Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you
take it right down Broadway. Touchdown! Saquon Barkley, 35 yards, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line.
We're not throwing another pick.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game. It leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
Yeah, a little bit of humor. Got to laugh that one off, and not the ha-ha. That was very funny, but kind of like, can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. He's going to let one go deep for... Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. A big play that time for the Raiders. 42 yards. On first and 10, here's Vic. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. A good response by the defense, sending them backwards after that huge gain last play. Another try after the first down sack. Vic, and the pressure gets to him again. Lawrence Taylor picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
Okay, let's go back a little bit and see if my schooling comes to the front. What's that old saying? Those who forget the lessons of history are doomed to repeat them. That's the same guy who's gotten back-to-back sacks. I think a double team may be in order.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
It's going to...
Vic to throw on fourth down. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line.
Oh, my God. Should we just... I feel like we should say goodbye to... Yeah, him. Devontae Parker.
I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping. Buy me by itself. I could get it by myself. Yeah, I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me by a cell. I could get it by myself. I just ran a checkup on myself. Some days I just have to check up on myself. I'm so icy, got that GG on my belt.
It has happened.
Thank the Lord for my people and my health. Lost a lot, but I came out with no L's. Thank the Lord for my people and my health. And I'm fine as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another cell. He still buy me by a cell. I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself, yeah.
How much does he go for? Please, expensive, he's expensive. So, Jerry Rice is 88 overall now, boy.
I will not crash. They will not stop me. Tenfold, copy, end zone. Watch me celebrate. I'm
godly.
I do my dance. Jump in the stands. No man, a man. Oh, deal with the hands. Thought he could guard me. I ruin their plans. I do what I want. They do what they can. Got it on. Smash. Put on the gas.
I will not crash. Honey, y'all.
Dash. Honey, y'all. Got it on, smash, foot on the gas. I will not
crash. They will not stop me. Tenfold, copy, end zone. Watch me, celebrate. I'm cocky. I do my dance. Jump in the stands. No man, man. Oh, deal with the
Donald Dockett.
Try to get guard me. I ruin their plans. I do what I want. They do what they want. They slept on the team that they owe me. I need a ring and a trophy. I say I'm the best as I am. There's no need in keeping it low key. I can call for the D like a turkey. I run straight through the D like a train. This year we ain't taking no losses. It's all about making the game. I hear a lot of trash talk. You call us up making a name. I put on the jets to cause regret even letting them stay in the game. Team on. I'm the lion in the jungle. You just try not to fumble. Rumble, young man, rumble. Never slip nor stumble. I take off, ooh, magic. Now watch me juke through the traffic. Footwork fantastic. Dominating every facet. Treat the pocket like plastic. Here come the blitz, pass it. Got it on, smash. I will not crash. Honey, y'all, dash. Honey, y'all, dash. Honey, y'all, dash. Honey, y'all, dash.
Dude, I'm gonna upgrade all my guards, oh my god. Upgrade Barry. So he needs a new card. And now he does.
Big numbers. Big numbers. 100 minute bag. That's a big number. Big numbers. Big numbers.
Yeah, foreign cars, foreign seats with the foreign leather. Foreign number, put the card in the ATM in the said era.
I'm working all my trees.
iPhone don't got a jet mode. If you wanna come, let's go. We ain't going nowhere special. I just wanna see Modesto. It's your thought, I'ma catch those. Mexican, I'm a pesos. It's your sons, I'ma place those. Never save, no name though.
Now he's an 88 overall. The weakest guard.
Big numbers.
Big
numbers. 100 minute bag. That's a big number. Big numbers. Big numbers. Whole team got it. That's a big number.
Yeah, wrist man. Check the wrist man. Got him out. Man can't ball like this, man. Lord, pass the pig skin when he stretch a distance. I'm talking a few hundred thousand yards. You just on your fifth, friend. Run it up, 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 count it up. Hey, hundreds and fifties and twenties, no fives and no singles, don't count on them. Hey, she wanna
play
me cause I blame she can't count on him. She tried to be nosy and hit on my ex. She like, girl, you can count on him.
We need more, tell him we need more. Put numbers on the board, let them keep the score. 16 cars on my front yard. 30 on my wrist, what a point of guard. Big numbers, big numbers. 100 minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. Whole team count it, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. 100 minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, blue punts.
I do this for the family. I might just blow my wheel. I'm keeping it so for real. Who feeling that glowing hill? I'm giving a soldier chills. My jewelry coat is chill. Stories treacherous. I effortlessly show them skills. Yeah. Pippers up the edge like I don't know no feel. See the pain deep in my eyes. They know it's real. Yeah, been this way. Right before the deal. Say this one for your photo reel. Show them skills. You ain't gotta tell me. I know I'm ill. Stories treacherous. I effortlessly show them skills. Yeah. How about it? How about it? You want it? You have it? You got it? Go snatch it. Start the line. Go ahead, jump it. How about it? How about it? Rep for your prom. When your post department, your projects. Pain driven. Itching, drumming. Look how far we coming. Heartbeat on the streets. Can't do it. Ain't built for the weekend. Sweet. This sugar. One man on me, but get deep. Watch what you doing. You wish you could. I do this for the family. I might just blow my wheel. I'm keeping it so for real. Who feeling that glowing hill? I'm giving a soldier chills. My jewelry coat is chill. Stories treacherous. I
guys, I'm back. My dad's already wearing my favorite running back jersey. And his name is Bo Jackson. Yes. I like the Raiders, okay? Oh, shoot, what? 88 overall? But yeah, guys, hope this. Raiders, I mean, they're better than the Chiefs at least, okay? You guys can't lie about that. They've been in more Super Bowls. They've won 3 Super Bowls. They won. They've been in 2. I think they've been in 2 or more. It's just their car isn't good in cold weather. Like me, I'm not good in cold weather.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Now the elder statesman of the NFL, Adam Vinatieri, set to get us started. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. And he'll take this across the 25, couple of extra yards, up to the 27-yard line.
It's his players. Do the best 3 plays. Just showed up. The stretch, the toss, and the speed.
On first down, it's Jackson. He'll have a first down past the 40. And finally taken down at the 35-yard line. A big pickup of 38. Got to give a nod of appreciation to some of those guys up front over on that left side. Several key blocks sprung him.
No appreciation for the guys from the backside that didn't allow any leakage and anybody could run him down from the backside.
They're at the kids' table.
Okay, so front side guys, good, backside guys. Man, that's what you're supposed to do.
I've had better.
Okay, either way, worked out quite well, didn't it? A nice sizable gain.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he fights his way into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Raiders drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. Extra point by Stenerud, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game.
Get your Super Bowl predictions.
Following the touchdown, here's Stenerud to kick it away. This is taken at the 3.
Let's go Chiefs. I'm going for Chiefs all the way.
And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line.
Now I can't say
they'll run on first down. Dickerson. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. On second down at 4. Jackson, and that gonna be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down.
But when you're going up against a talented receiver like that, you just know that they're gonna bring more people to him, right? They're gonna double cover him every chance they get.
I think that is what we're gonna see all game long, an early taste of that double, maybe even sometimes triple coverage we might see.
Yeah, I think what they're counting on, his talent to sometimes beat that double coverage.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 47. Now it's Jackson. It's complete. Stills. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. First and 10 right at the 20. Forced out to his left. Now he'll pull it down. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down.
Obviously, a big play was needed. And you can see his eyes light up as he realized there's absolutely no one in front of him. And he takes off and goes. It goes a long way. Not only does he pick up a first down, but a big gain to boot.
And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the six. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down. Second and goal from the six this time. Now Jackson. And it's caught. And he gets into the end zone for the touchdown. From 6 yards away, as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Vinatieri connecting on the extra point, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This is feeling at the goal line. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Working out of the gun, Michael Vick. He's going to take off with it. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
Well, there was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 19 there as the drive marches forward. Well, this might be a free play for Vic. And this one drops incomplete, but I think the defense jumped. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. A big play that time for the Raiders. And even 50 yards on the ground. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line. Second and goal. Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. And he's in. Touchdown, Raiders. Taking it in from 4 yards out, and the Raiders have taken the lead. That's an old-fashioned death march there, partner. Took them a lot of plays, but hey, they did the job.
And the defense always preaches getting off the field, making a play, and turning it back over to their own offense. Unable to do so, a long, sustained drive by the offense.
This will be taken short. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run-pass mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit with play action and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. Now it's Jackson. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. He's got the first down inside the 10. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield. A really nice pickup.
Jackson. And he will take it in for the touchdown from 3 yards out, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Now the offense will stay out there. They're going to line up and try for two. Jackson toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Tough there. Good pass. Hit the hands. He just couldn't bring it in.
And every receiver's coach everywhere seeing that play, focus, focus, focus. Watch it all the way in and tuck it away.
Great job by the kick team there to get the football, but also don't forget about the man that started it, the lonesome kicker himself.
I love that you brought him into it, because he doesn't get nearly the attention he deserves. Oftentimes, it's only when it's negative. In this case, he created a positive play for his team.
16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefit.
Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And the Raiders pick it up.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football game?
Should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball.
Gave him a loss, or gave those guys a win, both of us a loss. Because I have to go right now. I have to see the Super Bowl champions win. Or just the Super Bowl win. A game that everyone has been waiting for. Chiefs versus 49ers. Super Bowl 54. How do I get 4,000 coins? It gave me a loss. Great. It's totally good. So we will be opening up the is it the most expensive? Oh, look, 80 overall. That's not bad. That's all 13,000 points for one overall. It's crazy. We'll get some more players. We're almost done with this set. Let's get you. Cards away from finishing this. That's expensive. $1,000. And the rest of them are gonna be $1,000 too. But 11 cards from finishing this thing. Yeah, I'm 4 coins away from being that. I'm a card now. He's written. Nope. I wish. He's written. Bro, 11 cards. That's insane, actually. If you ask me. Almost Mel Renfro coming to this squad. But hope you guys enjoy the Super Bowl and this video. Peace.